the producers of Gulf War One and Gulf War Two and the soon-to-be-made Gulf War Three. Welcome to Opposite Land. It may seem counterintuitive, almost topsy-turvy, but by raising the deficit, your government will create pressure to restrain spending. That's why the present administration, with the help of Congress, would like to increase the current $300 billion deficit. With the cost of war, we might just hit $400 billion. Maybe even $450 million, thus preventing unnecessary and wasteful expenditures on social programs. You see, only by overspending can we hope to curb spending. You know, like cutting timber to keep it from burning, or saving Social Security by making it less secure, helping the poor by lowering the taxes of the rich, making higher education more accessible by raising tuition, and making the world safer by starting wars. Welcome to Opposite Land. I think I see a pattern emerging. Pattern? And salaries by 13%. Next, privatization. So formerly state-run utilities are sold to private industries, and they don't have to be in Argentina. Like selling off the rural water systems to Vivendi of France, the provincial banks to Fleet of Boston, and the pipelines to Enron of Texas. How about market-based pricing? To eliminate outdated labor contracts and charging user fees for visits to government hospitals. And don't forget free trade. For example, make sure those nations don't require import licenses on foreign-made items like cigarettes from you know where. By following these basic guidelines and using your imaginations, in no time at all, you'll have those global economies running just as well as can be expected.
Whoa! I'm sorry, No. We should have practiced more. I mean, they call us at the last minute, and we...
Excuse me.
Yes?
It's not our policy to apologize to the public.
But we made a mess.
The public is aware that in globalization, regime changes, and juggling, there are transition periods of untidiness. Oh. Hey, are those ancient Mesopotamian vases?
No, they're modern juggling clubs.
Oh, well, they look just like vases. Well, they're shaped like them. I mean, who can tell vases apart anyway, right? What's old? What's new? Oh, and by the way, just to be clear, when Western archaeologists raid tombs to supply museums, we call it scholarship. But when a desperate mob in a broken society raids a museum for their piece of the post-war pie, we call it looting. Can be confusing, don't you think?
No.
Perfect. As you were.